and welcome to Splunk Education. In this video, we'll discuss how to SSH into a server using the PuTTY SSH clients in Windows. Before we get going, you'll need to ensure you have PuTTY installed on your computer, as well as the PuTTY Gen converter tool if you're using .pim authentication. There are several places you can download the applications from, but this video won't cover the installation process. Next, you'll want to make sure you have your server credentials handy. For Splunk courses, your instructor will have sent out lab instructions or an email with your credentials for logging in. Sometimes the credentials will simply be a username and password, or you might also be sent a .pim authentication key, which needs to first be converted to .ppk so PuTTY can read it. We'll cover both methods of authentication in this video. Let's start with the username password method. To get started, launch the PuTTY application. In the hostname field, you'll enter the IP address for the server you're connecting to. Enter the port number provided by your instructor into the port field, or just leave this as the default setting if you weren't given a specific port number to use. The connection type radio button should be set to SSH. Click the Open button at the bottom of PuTTY. You'll likely see a message for the first time indicating that the server you're attempting to access may or may not be trustworthy. Make sure you've entered the correct IP address, and then once it looks good, proceed by selecting Accept or Connect Once. At this point, a command prompt window will open with the line reading Login As for you to enter your username. The next line after you enter your username will be your password. Please note that you won't actually see your password enter as you're typing it in. If you've correctly entered everything, you'll now be logged into the server remotely and can proceed as usual. Now let's go over .pim authentication. As mentioned before, PuTTY doesn't natively work with .pim keys, so they'll need to be converted first to .ppk using the PuTTY Gen application. Launch the PuTTY Gen application. Then, choose the RSA radio button for the type of key to generate. You can also choose SSH2 RSA if you don't just see RSA. Next, select Load. PuTTY Gen displays only PPK files by default, so you'll need to select All Files from the dropdown to see your .pim file. Select your .pim file and choose Open. PuTTY Gen displays a message indicating the .pim file was successfully imported. Select OK, and then choose Save Private Key. Choose Yes to save the key without a passphrase for the sake of ease. Enter a unique name for the new file and select Save. Now we can use the new PPK file to log in using PuTTY. Launch the PuTTY app and enter the server information just as before. In the left-hand menu, under the Data menu, go ahead and enter your username as you normally would. Under SSH, and then Auth, select Browse, and choose the .ppk file that you created with the PuTTY Gen app. Back up top under the Session menu, give your session a name, for example, Splunk Lab Connection, and then select Save. You can now select your saved session from the list, and it will automatically log in. You may get a message that the host key isn't cached in the registry. You can either select Accept to save to the cache, Connect Once to allow a one-time connection, or Cancel to terminate the connection. You'll be connected and can proceed as normal. Thanks for watching this quick demonstration of using PuTTY in Windows. Be sure to check out our other content and keep an eye out for future videos. Happy Splunking!